physicist. And today I'd like to bring to you another one of my articles. This one is entitled Town in Peru Destroyed as Earth's Surface Breaks Up Due to Planet X. Now, the town of Luto in the Cututu region of Peru has been destroyed by fissures that started appearing in 1998. At that time, the fissures were small and the authorities told the inhabitants to fill them up with rocks. But the fissuring continued and grew worse. Then in early March of 2018, the ground sank and broke into hundreds of blocks separated by cracks that were 2 to 38 meters deep. The town was destroyed and the cracks are still growing in size. And as you can see, this is what that ground looks like now. It's all broken up with these cracks between the blocks of ground, and these cracks continue to grow. And you can see one of these deeper cracks that have developed. As you can see, it's quite a deep crack there. You can see the person standing there gives us a good perspective of the size of this fissure. Now, the official story, as in many other cases, is designed to make this type of occurrence appear to be normal. Thus, news stories usually refer to the event as having been caused by a landslide, which then led to fissuring. However, the fact that the fissuring started in 1998 indicates that the fissuring led to the ground sinking and sliding, and not the other way around. The other idea, which is usually promoted, is that rain seeping into the ground has led to the fissuring. If this was possible, this should have happened long before now and been happening in many regions around the world for the last 1,000 years. But it clearly has not. This is clearly a new process and it must have a cause which cannot be explained by normal, well-established processes, especially since this is actually a planet-wide phenomenon. And you can see another photograph here of the buildings that have been destroyed by this cracking and how the ground has moved. Now, this is not a normal occurrence, but a symptom of what is occurring to planet Earth. Earth is expanding, and that is leading to the surface of the Earth breaking up. This is not the only area of the Earth experiencing fissuring. The African Rift Valley is also experiencing the appearance of large cracks overnight, and there are many other regions where cracks are also appearing. So this is the African Rift Valley region. You can see a large fissure that has opened up, and these fissures are now opening up literally overnight, and this is supposed to be a process that geologists believed would take millions of years, but it's now just happening overnight. This is a region of the world, a rift region, where eventually this part of Africa will break up and be separated from the rest of Africa by ocean. But the process was supposed to take millions of years, but now these fissurings are appearing overnight over kilometers and kilometers, or miles and miles in length. And thus, it won't be long before the ocean can actually get in and separate these two parts of Africa. And you may look at Article 282 entitled The Earth in Upheaval, Magma Rising, for more details. And these are other regions of the world where fissures also have been appearing. This one is in India. This one's in Saudi Arabia. And this one is in New Zealand. So this is occurring worldwide. Now, since this is a global phenomenon, it has to be caused by something which is affecting the planet as a whole, and therefore something which is outside the planet. And in fact, the cause is the invasion of our solar system by the Planet X system. The system is made up of dead or energy-depleted stars and planets, which absorb energy from other celestial objects. And as the energy of these objects decreases, they expand. Thus, the Planet X system is causing the Earth to expand, which is leading to the fissuring or cracking of its surface, and also to unprecedented volcanic activity. You may look at Article 247 entitled The Effect of the Planet X System on the Earth for more details. The objects seem to have started coming in about 170 years ago, and thus their effects are slow in developing but progressive. This means that the breaking up of the Earth's surface will continue and it will spread. So what we see occurring in Peru will eventually happen everywhere as the Earth continues to expand. And here we see one of these Planet X system objects. You can see these are huge objects because this is a sun which is 100 times larger than the Earth. The Earth would just look like a tiny speck compared with the sun. So these objects are much, much larger than the Earth. Most of them are larger than Jupiter, and some of them are even larger than the sun. So this is one of the objects which we can clearly see is in the sun's corona. It has made a plasma connection with the sun. That's one of the ways they absorb energy from the sun. They also lose their outer layers because their energy has dropped to such an extent that their surface layers break up and move off into space. That's why we see specks of matter floating around everywhere. And you see one of them here. This one's about half the size of the sun. And these specks of material are part of the layers of the material which they shed. In other words, their surface layers, in fact, they've come down to layers that are just above the core of the object, are breaking up and breaking off and floating out into space. Basically, they are being shed. And this happens until the core of the object is exposed, which is why I have called them stellar cores. And you may look at Article 259 entitled Large Planet X Object and Debris in the Inner Solar System. Because these clumps of matter come in different sizes, from dust sized to moon sized. But I call them debris because they are parts of these objects that has been breaking off them. Now, dust and clumps of matter shed by the objects are continuously entering the Earth's atmosphere, and objects which are small moon size are in orbit around the Earth. And you may look at Article 295 entitled Why Are So Many Blood Moons Being Observed for more details on that. All these drain the Earth of energy and thus cause it to expand. The reason why loss of energy leads to expansion is the same reason why the objects can hover close to the sun and not collide with it, and why they lose their layers of matter until the core is exposed. And that is because gravity is associated with energy. Thus, it's an energy depleted object has low gravity, and as energy is lost, an object loses gravity until it cannot attract its own matter inwards. So it expands and the upper layers break and eventually float out into space. At the moment, the Earth's loss is still small, so the only effects we see is the breaking up of its surface as it slowly expands. In conclusion, the fissuring which has destroyed the town of Luto in Peru is due to the Earth expanding as a result of the effect that the Planet X system is having on it. This is therefore something which is said to continue to occur and increase in severity and incidence around the world. This is Dr. Claudia Albers, Planet X physicist. Thank you for watching.